He makes his walk. He's fighting out of Connors MMA. He's bounced around weight classes a couple of times. He's got a win at 170. He's got a loss at 170. He's got a loss at 185. And now he's finding a home at 175 in a catch weight, seeing what he can do to mix up an in-between weight class.
Yeah, John Ciampa, he's coming from Connors MMA. Very good camp. He got a lot of guys over there. Very good jiu-jitsu. His last fight, we called his last fight. Looked real good in that fight. Came up short. This will be a very tough test for him.
There's one thing we know about John Ciampa, is we know he is durable. He can take a shot. He can take punches. He can take kicks. He doesn't like backing up. He's always coming forward trying to find homes for his strikes. And he's got a big test out of Junico's Tommy Lee Davis, who actually holds a win over Ciampa's teammate, Dave Sheehan, who will be fighting later tonight.
Right, yeah. Like you said, super durable, John Ciampa. We saw him in his last fight. The two guys, they just threw down for three rounds, and John Ciampa was game the entire time. I expect a lot of the same this time around as he enters the cage.
He makes his trot around the cage, rocking some green shorts tonight, the hair flowing.
It's got to be the hair, Andy. It's beautiful.
It says something when you choose U2 as a walkout song. You can't hate on that. All right, you made your trot, John Ciampa. It's not a marathon. Junico's third fighter about to make his walk to the cage. Ciampa's running again.
John Ciampa is pumped up. Oh, don't call it a comeback.
Tommy Lee Davis, he's 2-0 as a middleweight. He's making his debut at 175. I talked to him yesterday at the weigh-ins. He said cutting the weight was a little bit of a challenge, but he made weight. He got on the scales at 175. And he's looking very much refreshed here, rehydrated well. He's a massive 175-pounder.
Yeah, Tommy Lee Davis, this guy's a stud. He's huge, like you said, at this weight class. Another Junico guy. I actually saw his last fight at Combat Zone, where he actually took a kickboxing fight. He ended up coming up short in that one, but he looked good. He was actually training for an MMA fight that night, but his opponent dropped out and he ended up taking a kickboxing fight on like 24-hour notice.
That's a testament to how game he is as an athlete and as a competitor, because that's a totally different sport there, taking a kickboxing fight on short notice like that after training for an MMA bout. But we've seen his kickboxing in the cage before. His movement's tremendous. He's got very good power. He's coming out of a good camp in Junico. He's got a lot of potential, this kid, but it's gonna take a lot to put Ciampa away. Ciampa's as tough as they come. So it's a good catchweight fight. We're gonna see how he does with the lower weight class. We're gonna see how that weight cut affected him. I'm excited to see what he did. And on his Snapchat takeover, he seemed extremely confident. And he's looking extremely confident right now as he's getting patted down. Loco Lobo rocking his third shirt of the night.
Loco Lobo. He's also got crew Mark Delgrati in his corner there.
Our next matchup tonight, 175-pound matchup for three rounds, 3 minutes apiece. Introducing first, the unknown red corner. Here's an answer to number 1-2, representing Connors. His opponent, in the blue corner, with an answer of 2-0. Representing Team
The Tunico fighter, as always, receiving an extremely loud welcome. Referee Kevin McDonald can't wait to get this one started.
The
this
door could be- is shut. The door is locked.
And we're about to get this fight going. Our fifth fight of the evening, a touch of the gloves. Two experienced guys feeling each other out. Davis looking to time that right hand, but Ciampa does a great job ducking under, trying to utilize his wrestling. He's got a deep single attempt.
Nice wizard.
Lee Davis uses the wizard nicely to get back to his feet. Fighting an underhook. Trying to reverse position. Ciampa relentless with this wrestling attempt. Stopping the head down is Tommy Lee Davis.
Yeah, Ciampa went right in for that shot. Looks like he wants to get his ground game going early. Tommy Lee Davis, very long, very tall fighter.
Seems strong in there too. Ciampa diving for the single. Might have that attempt pretty deep. Excellent defense from Lee Davis.
Nice wizard toss.
That just goes to show the power of Tommy Lee Davis right there as he ragdolled Ciampa and lands on top.
Very nice.
A pass to half guard.
Super composed there as he passes the guard. He's got that underhook there.
Ciampa controlling the wrist. He's got an overhook on the left side. Lee Davis stepping over.
Bombs.
Big punches from the top. Ciampa covering up.
Oh, back of the head. Might have been the back of the head. I'm not sure.
Big punches to the body. Knee to the body, and that will do it. The power and ruthlessness of Tommy Lee Davis proved to be too much for John Ciampa. He got taken down. He got punched in the head a couple of times from half guard. And then when he rolled out of it, he gave up his back, and Lee Davis threw some big punches to the body, followed it up with a big knee, and Kevin McDonald saw enough and stopped the fight.
Yeah, that knee to the body definitely sealed the deal there. Looks like it's a bit of this little controversy here. Not sure. I just saw referee Kevin McDonald just went down to one of the judges. Now he's talking to one of the officials.
Do you think he's talking about a potential blow to the back of the head or a potential illegal knee?
That's what I thought initially, but John Ciampa didn't seem like he was complaining about it. Yeah, no, I guess that's it.
We'll see what the judges officially have to say as Harry Jones comes up with the official decision. With three finishes. We talked about he's got good power, good movement. He showed it again tonight. That weight cut didn't matter to him much as his power was there. He had a tremendous throw against John Ciampa, and he followed up brilliantly with some effective ground and pound.
Yeah, super dominant there. Got on top of him, dropped some bombs, threw that knee, and that was all she wrote. Very dominant by Tommy Lee Davis.
Junigo 3-0 tonight.